A system of linear equations in two variables consists of two or more equations. We're going to start off with looking at systems that contain only two equations. For example, these two equations create a system. And a solution to a system is a set of all points or ordered pairs that they both have in common. In other words, whatever works for this equation must also work for this equation, then that will be a solution to the system. For example, is the ordered pair 1, negative 2 a solution to the above system? So when we're given an option, an ordered pair to check, the first one will be the x, the second one will be the y, and I'll have to plug it into the first equation and the second equation, and if it is to be a solution, it must work for both of them. So we plug it into equation 1, and we plug the same ordered pair into equation 2, and the first one we get 2 plus 2, which is 4. So it works for this one, and that gives me motivation to go to check the second one as well. When I put 1, negative 2 into the second equation, I get 3, plus minus gives me a negative, and that also gives me 1 is equal to 1. So is this ordered pair a solution to the system? The answer is yes, because it worked for both of them. Now, is 4, 4 a solution to that same system above, this one that we're looking at? So this is my x, this is my y. I'm again going to go plug it into the first equation and the second equation to see what'll happen. So I've gone and plugged in 4, 4 for the x and y of the above system. That's going to give me 8 minus 4, which is a 4. So again, this gives me motivation to move on and also check the second one because it worked for the first one. 3 times 4 is 12 plus 4, and that looks like 16 is not equal to a 1. It worked for the first one, but not for the second one. So the answer is no, because they both don't share that ordered pair in common. Now, there are three things that could happen when we're looking at linear systems. And again, linear systems are the systems as above, like this one up here, which consists of one line and then a second line. And we want to know the solution, which is all the things they have in common. So the three things that could happen for linear systems in two variables, I am abbreviating here and writing two vars, I mean in two variables. What are the things that could happen? Well, I'm looking at two lines. I could have one line that maybe graphs into this, and another line that maybe graphs into that. And when that happens, I actually see one ordered pair that they have in common. This would be one solution that this system has, and it's called a consistent system. So that's one of the options that could happen. You go graph the two lines and you see that they meet exactly at one ordered pair. What are the other things that could happen? Well, the other thing that could happen is you look at your first line and then you look at your second line, and they both happen to be parallel lines. And if they're parallel lines, they're never going to intersect, they're never going to meet. So that'll be the case when there is no solution, and it's actually called an inconsistent system. So no solution, meaning lines are parallel, they never meet, they have nothing in common ever. Or a consistent system, they only meet in one place and they have one solution. The only other thing that could happen is you could graph your first line and maybe it'll look like that. And you graph your second line and it happens to be not only parallel to the first one, but exactly on top of that one. So both lines happen to be the exact same line, and this has infinitely many solutions. In other words, all the ordered pairs they have, they both share in common, and it's known as a dependent system. So the three options that we have, we could either have one solution, no solution, or they share all the points they have in common as infinitely many solutions. Solve the system by graphing. So I'm going to graph the first one and the second one, and I'm going to graph it by putting each one in y equals mx plus b or slope intercept form and isolating the y, because that'll give me an accurate graph. So I have y equals negative 2x plus 4, so I have a slope of 2 over 1 and a y intercept of 4 for the first one. Let's go get the second one ready as well. I have x minus y equals 5. I'm going to subtract x from both sides. Negative y equals negative x plus 5, divide both sides by negative 1, and we get y equals a positive x minus 5, so the slope of this guy is 1 over 1. So we're going to go graph the red line by starting on the y-intercept of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, And then the slope is negative 2 over 1, so I'm going to go down 2, 1 to the right, 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 or up 2 and 1 to the left, and then draw my line. Same thing for the second equation. The y-intercept is negative 4, so I'm going to start at 1, 2, 3, or I'm sorry, it's a negative 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then the slope is 1 over 1, so up 1, over 1, up 1, over 1, up, over, up and over, up and over, up and over, and that's enough to get a straight line. And it looks like there is a solution. This is a consistent system, and I can see clearly the solution is right here with the ordered pair 3 for the x and down 2, negative 2 for the y value. 3, negative 2 is the solution to the system, and if I wanted to double check, I would plug it into both of these and I would get a true statement. Okay, solve the system, determine whether consistent or inconsistent, and then if it is consistent, determine whether dependent or independent. So earlier I talked about dependent being if the lines overlap on top of each other. Independent really means that they go their separate ways and there's a solution and it's consistent. So let's quickly graph these. Let's take this guy and isolate y. So I'm just going to need to move the x over. And I have a slope of negative 1 over 1, it looks like. Let's do the same thing for this guy. I just need to move the x over. And that's going to give me y equals, messy, x plus 1. So this has got a slope of 1 over 1. So we're going to go graph the y-intercept, which is 1. And then slope 1 up, 1 over, 1 up, 1 over, 1 up, 1 over, or down 1, left 1, down 1, left 1, down 1, left 1. So there's our first line. Our second line has a y-intercept of 3 and a slope of negative 1 over 1. So I start on the y-axis at 3, then I go down 1 because of the negative 1, and 1 to the right, down 1, 1 to the right, down 1, 1 to the right, and then I got my second line. So we clearly see that this is a consistent system because it's got a solution right there. So consistent system. First question is determine whether it's consistent. It's consistent. I can read the solution. Ordered pair 1, comma 2, it looks like, is where they meet. And is it dependent or independent? Well, they go their separate ways. They're not the same line, so it is going to be an independent system as well. Same directions, part B for this problem, whether it's consistent or inconsistent, and then dependent or independent. So I have equation 1, equation 2. Equation 1, I've already isolated y. Y equals mx plus b, so it's got a slope of negative 2 over 1. I'm going to go ahead and isolate the second one for y. So subtract 4x from both sides. And then divide everybody by 2. And we get y equals negative 2x plus 5. And notice what happened. Both lines are exactly the same line. I'm going to go ahead and graph them anyway. If it says by graphing, we want to show the graph. So the blue line we've already graphed. The red line, same exact thing. Y-intercept of positive 5. Slope 2 down, 1 to the right, 2 down, 1 to the right, 2 down, 1 to the right, and so forth. And it happens to be the exact same line. So our answer is that this is actually a consistent system because there are answers, there are solutions, there are actually infinitely many solutions. However, it's a dependent system because they happen to be the exact same line on top of each other. Okay, let's do an application. It says 2 boxes of popcorn and 3 soft drinks cost $7. 3 boxes of popcorn and 2 soft drinks cost $8. Find the price of a box of popcorn and find the price of a soft drink. So we're looking for two things. I'm going to let x be the price of box of popcorn, and y will be the price of a box of soft drink. And the minute I choose to let these two unknowns be x and y, I must come up with two equations to find the answer to this word problem. So if you use two variables, you must have two equations or you must create a system. Now let's go back. Two boxes and three soft drinks, two boxes of popcorn and three soft drinks cost $7. So I have two of these items and each one costs X. So that's two of them at the price of X plus three of these guys at the price of Y. Remember, it's always how many items you're buying times the cost to figure out how much you're spending. Equals $7 is what you spend. The next one says three boxes of popcorn, so three of these guys, and two soft drinks, so two of these guys, cost a total of $8. So there's my system. Now I have to solve the system to figure out the price of the popcorn and the price of the soft drink. And as of right now, I'll go ahead and try my best to solve the system by graphing, because that's the main method we've used. When we get to the next two sections, we will solve them algebraically and we won't necessarily need to have a graph to get the answer to X and Y. So I have the first equation in red, isolated for Y, move the 2X, divide everybody by 3. And notice the y-intercept here, I'm going to have to approximate. It's 2.3333 and a slope of negative 2/3. The second equation, a little bit better looking. I subtracted the 3x, divided everybody by 2, and I have a y-intercept of 4 and a slope of negative 3/2. Now I'm going to go graph the two and see where they intersect. Wherever they intersect, I will have found x and y, which are the prices I'm looking for. Okay, I have the two lines graphed. The first one was harder to graph because I had to approximate about 2.3 right here for my y-intercept. And then from there, I took two full steps down, 1, 2, and then I moved over 3 to the right, 1, 2, 3, and I got this ordered pair. Then again, I moved two full steps down, 1, 2, and then 1, 2, 3 to the right, and I got this ordered pair, and there's my line. So that one was harder to graph. I had to be careful because I was approximating. The blue one wasn't so bad. Starting at 4 for the y-intercept, 1, 2, 3 down, 1, 2 to the right. Again, 1, 2, 3 down for the slope, 1, 2 to the right. I graphed that line, and I can clearly see that these two guys meet right here. It's a consistent system. They meet at the x-coordinate 2 and the y-coordinate 1. So that means x is $2 per box of popcorn, and y is $1 for the price of each soft drink. So by graphing, it was hard, but I was able to find x and y. Again, when we do elimination and substitution methods, you won't have to do the graph to get the answer.